you are.
Hi, my name is Pasha Kovalev.
And I'm Anya Garnis.
All right, welcome to Detroit, both of you. And of course, we know dancing is hot, ballroom dancing is hot because of shows like Dancing with the Stars, and So You Think You Can Dance. Although Burn the Floor was really around before all of that happened, wasn't it, Pasha?
Yes, it has been a long time, and Burn the Floor been on the market for almost 11 years now, so it's quite before Dancing with the Stars and So You Think You Can Dance arrived. But of course it had a career. Burn the Floor started in Australia, and then it's gradually traveled all over the world, end up here on Broadway in the United States, and now we're traveling around states. And it has been a great journey, I think, for everybody. And we are so happy to be here in Detroit. It's a little bit cold, but
yes, you arrived at the worst point of the winter, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Good timing.
Thank you. Yes, bad tour planning. Okay, I got it.
So, but obviously the TV exposure and the fact that you guys were on the TV show, that probably helps, right? Get the people know who you are and get out to see you live.
Yes, absolutely. A lot of people come to see the show because they, first of all, saw us, and they're familiar with the other TV shows which are out there promoting the dance, and people want to see more of it.
Anya, why do you think dance is so hot right now, or has it always been hot? It just seems like it's the popularity is just going higher and higher.
Popularity, I think I'm just glad dance is back, you know, and it's very, honestly, I mean, talking about TV shows, I mean, we've been introduced again what ballroom dance is. You know, even 6 years ago when I was teaching in New York, you know, no one even knew what ballroom is, you know, at that point. When I said I'm a ballroom teacher, they said, oh, ballet. So now, of course, thanks to TV shows, they reintroduced again us what ballroom dance is and how it can be. And, of course, Burn the Floor is taken just to the next level because it's so much more than you can see on TV, but just better because it's live. And, you know, you can never beat a, you know, live, you know, performance.
So what will people see in Burn the Floor? Is it just a bunch of different kind of dances, Latin and all the different styles, or is it a story as part told in dance?
Well, the great thing is about Burn the Floor that we don't have a story, but we do have short stories within each dance because it's partner dance, and so it's a man and a woman involved, so we have group numbers. And basically, Burn the Floor takes you through the journey of, through the all different eras of dance, how it was evolved from, let's say, 40s up into modern age. So we take one dance and we, you know, let's say swing or jitterbug, and now how it developed, and we ended up with a jive with Proud Mary and Tina Turner. So I think anyone can relate to it, and it's just absolutely ecstatic. It's energetic. It's a lot of energy exchange with the audience. The audience is involved because a lot of the dancers going through the audience and get them going. So it's an amazing show for everyone.
Do you think you can teach anyone to dance? You know, we have those of us who say we have two left feet, and sometimes when we watch the show, it's uncomfortable because you know some people are just never going to be really great at it.
what do you think, Pasha?
I think you can teach anybody. It just takes time.
But I would say as long as you're going to have a good time, that's all that matters. Yeah. As long as you're willing, anyone can dance, honestly.
But I mean, you both have been dancing probably since you were, what, 2 or 3 years old or something.
Well, a little bit later than that. Yeah. I started when I was 8, and Anya started when she was
9.
No.
Honestly, I feel that's the beauty of a ballroom dance because even teaching in New York, you know, a lot of couples come in, so it's actually open to anyone who is actually willing to learn. So you can come as an individual, or you can bring your kid, or you can, you know, come as a couple and have a wonderful hobby.
I'm guessing usually in the couple situations, the woman has dragged her guy there.
Most of the time,
yeah.
Yes.
But then does the husband or boyfriend eventually wind up enjoying it, you think, more than
you will be surprised, more than usual. And actually, they are the ones who are actually going to continue and, you know, and stay there longer and drag the other half eventually.
So you'd recommend that it's a good thing for couples to do?
I think it's a great thing. It's just a great exercise period, yeah. You know what I mean? So if they're both people willing to spend some time together and just have a great time, this is the place to be, in a dance studio.
So how does this experience compare, Pasha, being live on a stage as opposed to doing a TV show?
Well, being live on stage in front of all these people every single night is really a great experience. On TV, you have to project and think, oh, okay, a lot of people are watching you, but you're still kind of by yourself looking into this lonely eye of TV camera, trying to present it the best way you can. When you have live audience in front of you, the energy exchange which happens between the audience and the performers, it's right there. It's live, you can feel it, you can feel how excited the audience or how they feel the emotions you're trying to portray through certain dances. So it's like talking to you right now. I'm not just writing an email to you and send it over, but I can say exactly what I want to say, and I see your reaction right away, so we can have live communication.
That's, you pick up that energy from the crowd.
Yes, yeah. Yes, we give a lot of energy to the crowd, and we get a lot back.
Plus, you can't say when you're live, you can't say, oh, cut, let's do this over in your live.
Well, you'll be surprised, and yes, you can. No, I'm just kidding. But even on all these reality TV shows, you don't really have a choice of, oh, cut, something didn't go right. If it didn't go right, great, it's great TV, we'll put it there so everybody else can see, so you better not screw up in the first place.
Exactly.
So it's the same.
Well, what's your future, both of you? Are you going to do the show again, Anya? Will you be back on the TV show, do you think, in the future? Or?
Well, hopefully. Right now, I mean, we're taking one step at a time. Yeah. I mean, this is a great opportunity for us as a ballroom dancers, you know. So you think Anya's introduced us to think outside the box, gave us a little bit more confidence, and as a ballroom dancer, to be in this show, Burn the Floor, is an amazing experience. So for now, we're here and for a couple of months, and we'll see what's going to happen in the summer.
All right, and how about for you, Pasha? Do you think you'd want to be back on the show again in the future? Have you talked about that on the TV show?
It's always a great opportunity, and it's always a lot of fun to be there. It's a little bit different world, of course, but like Anya said, you never know. We'll take one step at a time. Well, usually with all those productions, whenever time comes, and it's usually the last minute, you'll know.
Yeah. Do you still watch? Do you watch the TV shows when you're not involved, or probably don't time?
Of course, yeah. Trying to stay on top of it and see what's going on, of course.
Right. And quickly here, before we let you go, is there you have a favorite number or a favorite minute in Burn the Floor that stands out for you?
Honestly, coming back to your question about how, you know, what's the most fun, how we interact with an audience, I think it's just to be at the end of the show, you know, when you do have 8 shows a week, the moment for me is just to be on that stage with all the dancers, with exchange of energy. We're always trying to find something that we can play off of, so it's always real, it's always fresh. So I would say just the interaction between all the cast, wonderful 20 amazing dancers all over the world. And so I think this is never the same. Every night is different feeling.
And for you?
I think we all have like little favorite pieces on a show which we maybe like to do the most. First of all, I totally agree with Anya. You every single show trying to find something new to keep it. I mean, doing it 8 times a week, kind of, it in a way becomes a routine, the same thing over and over again. But we try to fresh it up with different interactions within the cast on stage, making it interesting for ourselves. As far as a personal favorite, I would say it would be Anya's and I would dance together a very slow dance. It's rumba, it's contemporary, and it's about the story, about, like you were asking about the stories. The little story within that dance is this guy who just broke up with his girl, and he's thinking about her, and she kind of comes into his dream, and he's reliving it again. So that would be my favorite piece in the show.
Well, we're so glad you're both here today, and you can see Anya and Pasha and about 20 other dancers burn the floor. It's at the Fisher Theater through March 6th. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.